Wow! Wow! Man, this is really super dog mission.
What's up YouTube and welcome back to the channel once again. I am Varshik and I hope you people are doing really really great. Today I am here to review the beautiful retro classic ever. This retro classic, the Benelli Imperiali 400. So I have got some comments on my previous videos, the Benelli Imperiali accessories and the delivery one. So if you haven't watched those two videos, I'll give the links in the description. So go watch those two videos after completing this. So without wasting time, I'm gonna start off the review of this beautiful Benelli Imperiali 400. Unlike others, I thought I'll be showing you this beautiful bike in 120 fps shots, which would be like pure cinematic. So yes, cinematic shots coming up in 3, 2, 1, boom.
Benelli Imperiali 400. Really good and really retro.
So those are some quick cinematic shots of the Benelli Imperiali 400. So let's talk about the ride review of this Benelli Imperiali 400 and also the specifications of this bike.
So here we start the key and here we start the ignition of this bike. Whoa man, it sounds really good, sweet enough for a single cylinder bike. Sounds like a twin cylinder when it gets started. So here, this is the Benelli Imperiali 400 with us. So this is the shortest and quickest review on my channel, so please stay tuned and watch this whole video without skipping till the end. So the first impressions and the quick impressions are, this bike feels literally butter smooth man. The engine is really butter smooth, the response is quick enough, these indicators and plastic parts feel much premium. So finally we are onto the main road and let's check out the torque and the power ratio of this Benelli Imperiali 400. Whoa! 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 Man, this is really super torque machine when compared to its segment bikes, the other Classic 350 and the Java. Trust me, this bike can do lots of miles. It keeps you engaged every single time you ride this bike. The torque and the power ratio is enough to pull you out on the road. So the first question is, what's the price range of this bike? So the Benelli Imperiali 400 prices around 2.5 lakhs on road, as this is the black color variant, as you can see though. So this is the top of the line in the Benelli Imperiali 400, the color. So this costs like 15,000 more than the usual price of the Imperiali. I'm really impressed for this power ratio on this 400cc bike. You need good brakes on every bike, so let's check the brakes. The bike is now around 40 speed and it has got the ABS, the dual channel ABS. So you see that? You see that? That's freaking stopping. So the brakes are not that good, but the brakes are really sturdy and tough enough. See this. It takes like 1.5 to 2 seconds to stop the tires on the road. So the brakes are not up to the mark, I can say. The next thing is the fuel economy. If you ask about the fuel economy of this bike gives up to 25 to 28 km per liter on an average. That's good for a 400cc bike, because you are paying like what, 2.5 lakhs for a bike, and yeah, that's good enough. And because it's Benelli, so you can't expect much mileage from this bike. So when you compare it to the other segment bikes, the Classic and the Java, this gives a little bit less mileage. The next question is, can I do touring on this bike? Yes, of course you can do touring on this bike. The seating position is nice, relaxed. Like you can do lots of miles on this bike. But the thing is the ground clearance. The ground clearance of this bike is little bit low. Like a street triple, you have to, you know, when there is a speed breaker in front of you, you have to crawl on the speed breaker. Because I am coming from an adventure tourer, the suspension is not that good. But for this bike, it's okay. I can give like what, 6 out of 10 for the suspension. And the braking, 6.5 out of 10. These two are the bad things about this bike, which I observed in this short quick ride. Like you have to be very extra careful when you get into potholes or when there are speed breakers ahead. So there are a lot of comments coming on my previous videos to review the Benelli Imperiali 400. So here you go, the review is here. So let's check the top speed of this bike. So let's stop the bike actually. So the bike is now stable. Let's pull this bike and check out what this bike can give us. Here we go. Wow, that was nice. So this is a classic, you must ride it like a classic. But what I did was, excuse me for doing this on this bike, jokes apart. So let's do 0 to 60. 3, 2, 1, go. That was quick enough. The best thing about this bike is, man, these speedometers. You see these speedometers? They look really good and really retro. Like a Triumph T10 or the Triumph Bonneville. And the best thing is you get the fuel indicator here when compared to the Classic 350. The Classic 350 doesn't provide you the fuel gauge. But the Imperiali provides you the fuel gauge, as you can see over here. And this is the RPM meter. This is the speedometer, and here you get both of the trips, the trip 1 and the trip 2. Many of you are asking me, bro, how is the engine heat? So the engine heat is pretty normal. Like, you know, it's a 400cc, so you can expect a little bit heat on your legs, but not that much as my Himalayan does. But that's pretty much manageable here. And the exhaust is also purely good, if you can hear that. It's really sweet. As it's a Benelli, the turning radius is much lesser than other bikes. You know, you have to really take a long U-turn or long turn. So what I observed is the bad things are the braking. Second thing is the turn radius. And the third thing is the ground clearance. Yeah, am I missing anything? So if you really have any kind of doubts and any kind of questions, please be free enough to comment down in the below comment section. And please do like, share and subscribe this video. Do not forget to press the bell icon. And yeah, please do subscribe, man. It really motivates me to do much more videos for you people. Comment down what kind of videos do you want on my channel. So this is Varshik, and the camera angle changes in 3, 2, 1.
And the engine comes mated to 5-speed gearbox. And these two speedometers are really retro, which reminds me of the old school bikes. So if you are really interested to buy the best retro classic in the budget, please do go for the Benelli Imperiali 400 instead of the Triumph T10 or T120, because they are much more costlier. The Triumphs are really costlier, like prices are around 9 to 10 lakhs. And if you want a best looking retro classic in a budget, this is the good choice. So blindly go for the Benelli Imperiale 400 if you are looking for the best retro classic ever in the budget. So this is a quick review and a spontaneous review of the Benelli Imperiale 400. If you really have any kind of doubts and questions, please do feel free to comment down in the below comment section. So I'll be answering those comments, and probably if there is a good topic to make, I'll make it in the next video on this Benelli Imperiale 400. One more thing, please do like, share and subscribe this video. It really, really motivates me. Stay tuned for the next upcoming vlog. This is Varshik signing off. See you in the next vlog. Until then, keep smiling, keep watching my videos. Like, share, subscribe, do whatever you want. Take care. Bye-bye.